Well, High People Music Awards is a product of High People. And High People is a company that started in 2005 with development of the first ever social entertainment website all around East Africa. Social entertainment was because we believed that we had capacity to use internet to promote our art and our culture. And then by that, we were able to create employment for the youth, for women, and for girl children. So we had realized that there was a very big gap that internet was able to cover. Internet was able to help us cut costs in terms of production, in terms of advertising and marketing, our people, our content, our cultures, and our continent as Africa. And we went ahead to do highpeople.com, and down 3 years down the road, High People was the maker of every hit in town, because every song that went on High People became a big song in the diaspora. So when it became a hit in Uganda by any chance. Of course, we were thinking about different other types of content at that time, but we had issues of copyright, we had issues of finance to have the content in one place. So we couldn't do it with everyone, but at least we were able to serve the music industry diligently to date. The awards were part of the process. Initially, internally, we first called them People Awards. Later, we called them Uganda Music Awards, all the kind of names. But then, in the same generation, lived an amazing platform that was awarding and celebrating musicians in the Pearl of Africa, and that was called the Pearl of Africa Music Awards. And we don't believe in creating competition that is not necessary. So when we thought we had our concept, and when we were running High People charts and all that very successfully, we thought that our information, the data and the statistics we had could help actually better the position of the existing awards then. So what we did is we had to seek for them and partnered with them, being their exclusive digital partners, doing the developers of their online voting platform, and being their exclusive promoters of the award to the internet, to the world. Yeah. The time when we decided to roll out High People Music Awards was after internal business consultations and very many discussions with our team, and also having talked to the partners we had then and asking them about whether they were coming back or not, and they were not sure. And then we said, I think if they're not sure, the industry needs someone to be present and working, and we are in a better position to do this. So we decided to officially announce our own initiative.
I attended the first show, it was a bit more problematic. Some of the IT didn't work very well. So over the years, they've come improving that, improving the attendance has been good over the years. The first one maybe was not that fantastic. And the social media has really helped, because it can be promoted almost 100% on social media. Other media is quite expensive when you go into advertising on in newspapers and on television. This can be quite expensive, but I think social media has enabled them to reach people that they would not otherwise reach, and that has made it more successful, because most of the young people who are the ones interested in these awards are on social media.
Oh, sweetie baby, Mukamba,
and money must be a part of it. To have the glamour, to have a red carpet that is 100 meters, it's all money. And it has to go in one day or two, yeah? And I'll first of all say I'm thankful to God that we've not only been able to weather at the storm, but we've been able to grow over the time. The High People Music Awards that happened first on the 12th of May 2012 as the High People Chats Festival is not the High People Music Awards of today. Today, we crown ourselves and we are proud to say we are the most consistent award in Africa that is still living, running for 9 consecutive times every year for 9 years. We're the only ones. No one has such a record. I'll tell you to hide nothing that the awards don't make money yet. Why? Because the ecosystem was maybe spoiled by maybe some of the players some time back. The awards don't get sponsorships from our people. That's why we tell you we're sponsored by God. The only way one is able to have awards run, one is you must be well involving and inclusive of the stakeholders of the industry with so much respect for everyone's contribution. Two, you must believe in the industry more than the business of the awards, because it's true that the big award brands in the world make billions of dollars, and it's very true, it's a very big and viable business. But we are in a third world country, and we are in Africa, and we need to grow through steps. Even today, and even 100 years from now, as long as God gives us life and keeps High People going, the awards are going to happen every year without fail. Give me with the fire, yeah. Every time you know retire, yeah. You know deceive, you know liar, yeah.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I want to thank God that brought me this far. I want to thank a team that gave me a foundation in this music industry, Team No Sleep. I want to shout out to Kabako, Rod and Y, for sitting with me on my first project. Big up on yourself. I respect you so much. And to a team that is always behind Nina Rose, I call you my Rosebuds. Thank you so much. Continue loving and supporting me. Shout out to you, Boombox Records, my new management, yeah? I love you so much. I'm so humbled, High People, to be part of the Hall of Fame. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Cole.
Well, we've been booed by even the media itself. First of all, because we know there was truth about, for example, the stories that were being written about the popular and famous musician Bebe Cool. He's a friend and brother to me, yeah, but he's a friend for the industry and to so many people. It happened, and you know, always somebody says that it's a matter of time. One of the things that really most affected us then was the fact that we had so many accusations by the media, especially the print media. And we had to stand our ground and go to court. And thankful to God, we were able to win every single suit that we filed against the media houses. Why? Because we knew there was nothing wrong we were doing. But importantly, we were able to make lines clear. And because the musician himself was not able to run through the same challenge, he had to opt and ask for being out. And High People Music Awards has a very clear written policy, an exit policy, that allows any musician to say if they don't wish to be nominated or be a part of the competition, to write and say we don't want to be a part of it. And he did, and we said it's okay, we honored his opinion, and we said he shouldn't be part of the organization. But importantly, we were also able to win the battles that were in the market, because when we went to court, justice was pronounced. Yeah, we were able to have the right truth tabled. We were able to have those who said the wrong about the organization of the project apologize. I'll tell you, we are very confident that we are a very important stakeholder in the creative arts industry. And no one can say they can downplay the importance and relevance of High People in music especially. And like you mentioned, there were a number of musicians that were not interested. But like I said, we have an exit policy, and it's very free for anyone to exit. The only challenge is that it is not free for someone to come back. Why? Because the policy marks a number of years, starting from 5 years of being excluded, yeah? Depending on the decisions we make internally. We never make them public because it's not a matter of any public interest. It's a policy that we know that this guideline is about making sure if someone exited, then we need to make sure we review them for some good time and understand if they appreciate the project. And if they never do, then it is fine because it's really opinion, yeah? But importantly, you will see that even the number of those who used to criticize has fallen down to almost 100%. Our consistency is not by any chance just a kind of luck. It's a blessing that has been out of so much persistence and so much hard work. And we value and respect our work. I'll tell you, for many times we've had different stakeholders wanting to bribe our system, wanting to, you know, someone cluelessly calls you and they tell you, I want to buy 3 tables and I win an award. And there is record. We've actually taken some of them to police sometime, yeah? We've mentioned some of them in the public domain to make sure we cap down the thought of someone thinking that they should pay to win an award, for example. So, over time, those who really follow the industry have been able to understand that whether you are a friend to us, the only way you have to win a High People Music Award is through being voted.
I think they have overcome by using information technology. The voting is online, so even if you wanted to cheat, it is not easy. And I think people therefore trust it a little bit more than where it was judges. This is the people's vote. The judges do come in, I think, just to fine-tune it, but otherwise it is the people's vote and we know we have voted or you have not voted. So if your candidate doesn't win, you know it's probably your fault. So that is what I think has made it more credible than some of the others which had depended on judges.
High People delegates, I'm really humbled to give out this precious award to a great son of Uganda by the names of Navio. Congratulations.
Basu Nivanyo. Hi. Wow. I think am I getting emotional for the first time? First of all, no one told me it's been 10 years. I feel like it's been 2. Thank you so much for the support over these 10 years. I'd like to thank God first and foremost, my beautiful family, my beautiful mother who always inspired me, who gave me the gas when people told me I couldn't do it this way or that way. Mom, you're a big inspiration to me, so thank you for giving me the energy, the bravery, through all the disrespect and all the little haters out there. I could always smile in their faces because I had my mother with me. So keep disrespecting. You know why? You know why I can stand up to you. On the other hand, I'd like to thank my father as well. My family, all of them gave me that backbone. I'd like to thank the producers I started out with. The first person who ever recorded me was a young gentleman by the name of Steve Jean when I was 10 years old. He saw something in me alongside Hope Mukasa and they put me in the studio for the first time. I'd like to thank all the people I came up with after that, Dao, D&D, Damba. After that, Ali at Talent Africa, we started something together that he's gone ham with. I'd like to thank Nav Corp, all my people that you see up here on stage. Aleku. Yeah. Flex. I'd like to thank Clear Cut. Those are the brothers I came into the game with. Those are it goes without saying. When you see me up here, it's all of us. Most of all, I'd like to thank the fans. Thank you guys so much for supporting me. I can't believe it's been 10 years, and let's keep pushing. People told us as Ugandans that we couldn't amount to much, They told us as Ugandans, every award show, you know, that I went to, I'd be the only guy there. And now, when I look around, there's 5, 10 of us, 15 of us. Let's take over Africa. Let's take over all the awards. We've got the most talent here. Rest in peace, radio. Thank you guys so much. Much love and respect.
Hi, people. Is the king of digital in this region in East Africa. I would say that without any fear. We have very good appreciation of what kind of technology has to be used, and we make good use of the technology you have in terms of voting. Yeah, if you remember and you've been following, we were the first ever brand anywhere in the world to establish and start what they call WhatsApp voting. Yeah, and WhatsApp voting is unique, identified by a number of a phone that is registered in someone's name, right? And those votes can be easily calculated, and you'll never find anyone forging. So no matter how much you walk into a cafe and vote, you'll never have a replication of a vote. Secondly, our voting system that we've been growing every single year since 2008, because we used to use the same system to aggregate the high people charts, We grew it into a totally people-centric platform where people have to vote, We've created a metric that allows us to make sure that we scrutinize every single vote. If the system allows someone to vote, for example, 24 times in a day, it means they have one unique vote in an hour. So there is no single day, a single computer, a single phone is going to vote 2 times in an hour. Never. It can never happen. So no matter how someone will go out pirating and trying to do a lot of voting because they see the vote is getting accepted, on our server side, it is very clear that it's only one vote that is being taken. So at the end of the day, we always have the right winners. For people who do research, they understand the difference of analyzing the qualitatives and the quantitatives of polls. And because we have this big data that comes in, we always make sure that the system screens it to the last bit. The most memorable award night is the most recent, the 9th edition. We knew about COVID. I was actually out of the country when the situations of COVID started. And when I returned, I knew what was happening in Europe, I knew what was happening in South Africa, and I knew we were going to have a problem. So we opted to cancel and postpone our event before the president actually announced a lockdown, about 10 days before or even more. So when we did that, because we had interest of the followers of and the supporters of the industry, and we knew that some of them actually travel from different countries to come to Uganda for High People Music Awards. And we thought it was not healthy enough for us to accommodate 3,000 people in one event. And what if they end up all having corona infection? But then, to preserve the prestige and the glamour of the event, we say that as we do announce the winners, we should not give out any accolade. Why? Every musician deserves and desires to receive their award in public at a glamorous event with their fans celebrating. So we said, no, let's announce the winners, but let's keep the accolades for 2021. So as long as God allows and we get through this situation, we are going to have a very big 2021 event. Why? Because we're going to have so many winners for 2 years celebrated. We are going to make sure we invest more in our red carpet. We did 150 meters last year, so now we might have to do 300, 400 meters. Why? We need to accommodate for more winners from more than 16 countries.
All right, I think we'll take it to the next category. Let's see the best R&B song, Alan Tonics and Philip Falling, Cosine Kayayana, Jami Culture Nkuluoza, Maro Njagala, Navio featuring King Saha, Nkwagalomu, Slick Stewart and DJ Roger, Sunday, featuring Alan Tonics.
Those are all bangers.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see who the winner is.
I said it.
DJ
Slick. I needed this gentleman, the song for the women. Baba Tonda Kusande.
Man. Baba Tonda Kusande, Alan Tonics, DJ Roger and DJ Slick Stewart. Thank you very much.
Congratulations
on your win tonight. Yeah. Yeah.
Right. When you look at this, you just move to the soul. So, ladies and gentlemen, the mm-hmm. best soul song.
For me, at my age, there were a lot of negatives in that, you know. It's not as much fun as being in the same place, seeing how everybody's dressed. Meanwhile, last week they were all in pajamas in their sitting rooms. But seeing the dressing, the fashion that went with it, seeing the Honorable Minister there often, one of them. And this has been less exciting, I must say. But on the other hand, it was the only option. It was the only option. We cannot wait for COVID. That will be now, maybe the next year that will be coming along. So it was a very good idea to do it that way. I personally did not enjoy it as much, but I was there to watch it, and I was happy that it did take place without missing 2020, which would have been the case otherwise.
We believe so much in, as high people, we believe so much in women empowerment. And I always say this somewhere, but not in the same situation and the phrase of the question you've asked it. I think your question makes better sense to actually answer this. I remember in 2012, when we did the second edition in February 2013, Sheba was not nominated. And she called me asking me for a ticket to attend. Because she told me she wanted to see how the winners and the nominees look like. And maybe she could get inspired, yeah? But why I would say she's probably the most surprising winner for our side is that today, Sheba is the only female artist in Africa that has ever won Artist of the Award 3 consecutive times on record, yeah? She's the only one. All around Africa, no one has such a record. But secondly, the awards have been able to change her into a very, very, very big brand, into a dependable artist that you can always count on. They'll entertain, they'll surprise, they'll make an impact, even when you least expect them to. And she's had a very memorable 5 years of non-stop hits. And how can we even be proud as high people? Because I'm sure we've played a very important role in that success of Sheba. Every single year, when we get her to perform, she's celebrated the same way.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, high people. Wonderful event. Best female artist. Women's Month. We just went over Women's Day. Queen Sheba.
Can I say something? I want to tell everybody who thought I can't.
I met Innocent himself, and he's very, very dependable, very reliable, very determined, because it is a difficult sector to work in. But he has determinedly, with lots of difficulties, with limited support from other people. So I used to work for government and the entertainment industry, the whole creative industry is a priority sector for Uganda. So I decided to put my weight behind him where it can help. Not very much because I no longer work for government, but I decided I would support Innocent and support high people as an award ceremony that's really grown over the years and is credible.